from the Hallmark Hall of Fame collection.
The outcome has not been what we hoped.
She's never been wrong.
I can't get elected.
He's never been anything.
I'm just a beer vendor.
But one friendly bet is about to change everything.
I propose we get the local beer vendor elected to Congress.
That is awesome!
Julia Stiles from the Hallmark Hall of Fame collection.
It is so rare to see you speechless.
The Makeover starts right now on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries.
In a hurry.
So much for your invaluable support in my run for this congressional seat. Sadly, I was just informed the outcome has not been what we hoped. The words with which I might express my gratitude would never equal the tireless efforts put forth by those involved in my campaign, particularly my friend and campaign manager, Colleen Pickering. It is my sincere belief that all parties are working toward the good of the country to find solutions to the problems facing all of us. It is in that spirit of bipartisanship with which we thusly concede the election. And congratulate my opponent, Mr. Wade Bradbury. Thank you.
Well done. I know with only 60% of the polls in, some people think we jumped the gun on the speech, but with the numbers being what they are, I think the earlier the concession, the more dignity we'll keep.
Dignity being a state of mind.
Congressional candidate Hannah Higgins suffered a stunning defeat today, losing by a wide margin to former television weatherman Wade Bradbury. WZHA was on the scene for voter reaction.
Hannah Higgins? Nah, I didn't vote for her. She reminded me of my high school principal.
I liked what she was saying about education and stuff, but she's just so... I don't know. She's such a cold fish, you know?
Yeah, I voted for her, but only because the idea of voting for the weatherman was absolutely repugnant.
No. I voted for the guy from TV. The guy makes me laugh every time he does the weather, like when he goes over and says, now we'll go to the Doppler radar. Cracks me up to say, Doppler radar.
I'm going to tell you what her problem is. That lady talks like she's too smart for her own good.
As if creating legislation for 300 million people is a job for which intelligence is a disqualification.
Uh-oh, it looks like Wade Bradbury is about to make his victory speech. We don't have to watch this, Hannah.
It's not as if the evening could get any worse.
I want to thank all my supporters here and out there. I am honored that everyday people like you have chosen an everyday guy like me to represent you in Washington. Why don't we do this the way you guys like? I plan on bringing a high-pressure system of change to Washington.
With the support you've shown tonight, I'll
blow out the fog of old ideas and rain down prosperity and happiness. Now it's onward. Let's change which way the wind is blowing in Washington.
That's the problem. He doesn't know which way the wind is blowing. He's a terrible weatherman. Over 73% of his forecasts are inaccurate. He said that today was going to be bright and sunny.
And it's amazing how he tries to pass himself off as this everyday guy while he's standing there in a $4,000 Italian suit.
His parents built the wing of a library to get him into an Ivy League school, and yet he has the nerve to paint me as an elitist?
I don't think your undying commitment to proper speech helped.
I have no idea to what you are referring.
I don't think it hurts to ask yourselves who you'd rather have a beer with.
I believe you mean with whom one would want to have a beer.
This is the perfect example of our need to improve education. Frankly, I find her grammar appalling.
It wasn't hard to convince voters that you thought you were the smartest person in the room.
You've been in most of those rooms. We are.
Wish I had your problems. Must be nice to be too smart.
Suddenly, it seems everyone is a political consultant.
No, I'm just a beer vendor.
I beg your pardon? What's that?
I'm just a beer vendor. You know, deliver beers, kegs and such, pick up empties after they break down the bar, hand out samples here and there. Yeah, that sort of thing.
I do believe he's trying to communicate.
All right, go on, crack wise.
I think we met in the kitchen. It's Elliot, is it?
Yeah, Elliot Doolittle. Pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I think what Mr. Doolittle is trying to say is that he's a beer vendor.
Yes, I suppose I did catch some of that.
Oh, sure, yeah. Take your shots at me. You know who's having the last laugh here? Me. Because I voted for the other guy. Sure, he's lace-curt and Irish, but he don't seem like the kind of guy that would make fun of a fella. Matter of fact, he seems like the type, you know, pick up a sixer at a packy and talk about the Bruins.
We come to this. I'll have you know that there was more riding on this election than finding someone with whom you could discuss your precious Bruins.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, yes, here we go. This country once had one of the best educated populations in the world. Now we're ranked 33rd. As education flounders, crime and unemployment rise. But instead of addressing these issues, we'd rather elect weathermen to Congress and distract ourselves with reality television and the tattooed circus, otherwise known as professional basketball. Maybe we should just wallow in our demise, for which someone like you could be the perfect poster boy.
Yeah, well, just so you know, the Bruins ain't basketball. It's hockey. You should at least know what sports teams represent Boston if you want to represent Boston. I guess you're not quite so smart as you think you are.
What frustrates me is not how poorly you speak, but how unnecessarily poorly you speak. With a little education and effort, your insults could be as well-spoken as anyone's.
I suppose this means we're calling it an evening. Good night, Mr. Doolittle.
Yeah. Nice talking to you.
Think I talk funny?
No, sir. What are you going, Hoopy? You talk wicked good. Good as anyone I know.
That's what I thought.
Thank you so much for changing your schedule last minute and coming down to our school. I really think that meeting some of the new staff was tremendously helpful for them.
Oh, my pleasure. Colleen and I'll have an updated curriculum for the students with learning disabilities by next week, and the school board is going to visit to observe classes on Thursday. So in the meantime, if you need anything, call me at the office. Thank you.
Thank you.
Extra Pilsner over Clancy's.
Got it.
Yo, Frankie. Hey there, Elliot.
Hey, guys, listen up, okay? Mikey Carmichael's going to the hospital.
He's finally getting that thing removed.
And Mary Louise is on maternity.
So? We're looking for a replacement for the bowling team.
Uh-huh.
You think my wife's going to let me run around with a couple of beauties like you two's?
Stop it, you. You charmer. Hey, what about you, Elliot, huh? We could use a strapping fella like you on the team.
Wish I wasn't working nights.
Did you hear? Henkels is retiring.
Yeah, we're gonna be looking for a new sales rep.
Yeah, what's a guy like that make anyways?
Really?
What? You think just because we're in HR, we know everybody's business?
No, I think it's because you already know everybody's business is why they put you in HR.
Hey, look, you guys, it's confidential, okay? Can't really talk about it, but I can say he makes more than the two of you combined, and then some.
And then some on top of that.
Right?
Foku bucks.
Foku, big bucks. Trust.
Let's go.
I want to get a beer.
Hello.
Did you check out the morning news? I just sent you the link.
Check out? I'm not in a hotel. I'm getting ready for work.
It's a perfectly appropriate phrase, Hannah.
Maybe you could look at the link, and then you could check out Webster's,
A shocking turn of events today as freshman Congressman Wade Bradbury, in a hometown appearance here in Boston, held an ill-timed rally on the steps of the statehouse.
I'd like to introduce legislation that will clear up these issues for families. Much like the skies need clearing here today. We'll blow out the oppressive drizzle of taxes and bask in the sunshine of a brighter day.
Eyewitnesses report that the incident was quick and painless.
Oh, my. Exactly.
The governor of Massachusetts has expressed his condolences to the family and stated there will be a special election to fill the vacancy to take place not less than 4 months from now.
Venture capitalist Andrew Bridgeworth is here today, announcing his candidacy for the congressional seat made vacant by the tragic passing of Representative Wade Bradbury.
I look forward to bringing my extensive experience in the private sector to Washington.
This is why we've asked you here, to discuss mounting another run.
Yes, it would be necessary to address the major concern in all of the polling data, which comes down to Ms. Higgins's likability factor.
We need to work on your posture.
But I have perfect posture.
Which is exactly the problem. It makes you seem unyielding. Through a rigorous combination of yoga, Pilates, and Ukrainian folk dance, I plan on getting you to slouch more.
And the hair. No. Your hair. It says I am stuck in a sorority house production of Bye Bye Birdie.
I had no idea I had such chatty liberal arts hair.
But our bigger problem is you're a woman.
Are you suggesting I not be a woman?
I don't think we can do anything about that at this point. But women in politics face a double-edged sword. You're currently seen as unfeeling, which it's easier for a man to get away with. But if we go too far in the other direction, you could be seen as hysterical or flighty.
Another major problem is your wardrobe. I'd soften your image by putting you in sweater sets.
Really? We lost an election by 14 points, and you think that you could fix that with sweater sets?
Obviously, what you're currently doing isn't working.
I see. So if I understand you all correctly, the only way that I can win an election is by changing how I look, speak, and act.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Wait.
Okay. I will take that into consideration, and we will be in touch. Thank you.
That did not go in. Nope.
Perhaps this is what a frog feels like when it is dissected.
Hannah, I thought a few of their comments were valuable. I know it's not easy to hear.
There's Mr. Doolittle here to see Hannah.
Oh, sit. I'll take care of it.
Colleen Pickering, I'm Miss Higgins' business partner. Can I help you with something?
Yeah, hey there, yeah. I thought about calling, but then I thought I'd just, stop by.
Wait, aren't you...
Hey, you remember me? Poster boy.
Poster boy?
Yeah, it was election night. Your friend was hollering at me about being a poster boy for demise.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry. She was, well, in a mood that evening.
Oh, that was a rough night for her. Yeah, hopefully she's better now.
Not particularly, no. But can I please relay a message to her, perhaps?
Oh, yeah. Well, as she was taking off, she said something about teaching and stuff, and I'm thinking that's what she does.
Well, she's an educational professional.
Well, that's great. Yeah, see, there's this job. See, guys can be retiring sales rep for the Boston Colony Beverage Company. I work nights driving delivery trucks for them, so this would be a big step up, and, I'd be wicked good at it. The thing is, see, I already tried for a job like that before, and they turned me down. They said the job's all about, talking to people. And I was thinking, I can talk to anybody, but then I figured it out. It's not so much if you can talk to folks, it's how good you can talk to them, you know?
I see. So you're hoping to improve that?
Yeah. I figure the guy's doing the hiring, they talk like your friends, so that's probably what they're looking for, you know? So I'm just hoping she could teach me to talk good, you know? Or at least, you know, more better, you know?
Have you seen Pierce? I was wondering if you could find me some aspirin.
He's pulling something down in the file room, but he'll be back shortly. Hannah, perhaps you remember Elliot Doolittle? We met him on election night at the hotel.
I remember you were doing your best to insult me. Let me guess, you finally came up with a snappy retort?
Well, seems to me, you know, I was just trying to give back a little of what I got, you know? It wasn't exactly what I call nice, you know what I mean?
There is often a gap between those who are nice and those who are correct.
Mr. Doolittle came at your suggestion that he might learn some proper ways of expressing himself.
Yeah, and I got a little scratch stashed away so, you know, I could pay for lessons.
This is a consulting firm for educational institutions. We develop teaching tools and curriculums. I don't tutor remedial grammar and diction on an individual basis.
Well, my money is just as good as the next guy's.
Money is not the issue here. What is at issue is my time. I trust you can see yourself out.
Thank you for stopping by, Mr. Doolittle.
Oh, well, thank you. You have a good day.
Maybe later we could just go outside and kick some stray dogs.
I know. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. I was frustrated about your consultants tearing me apart. I kept yammering on about how, in order to become a more viable candidate, I must transform myself into somebody more likable.
From your behavior in the lobby, I can't imagine why they'd think that. You know, you bite somebody's head off, and then you wonder why they're electing the local weatherman.
Oh, or the local beer vendor.
Well, now you're being snippy, because nobody is electing a local beer vendor to anything.
But they might. Perhaps if likable wins elections, then even he could win. That is the third conversation he has had with a total stranger, and they've all walked away smiling.
Well, I wish it were that easy.
I've been hearing all morning about how the electorate is only interested in voting for everyday, likable people. I propose that they don't come more everyday and likable than your friend Elliot Doolittle.
My friend? Well, admittedly, he does make friends easily.
Wait, think about it. We could spend months trying to transform me into somebody completely different, or it appears we have somebody perfectly likable right there. You know that I'm thinking about running again only because I think that my ideas could really benefit people, but it is not about getting me elected.
Yes, in the canon of your faults, self-aggrandizement doesn't really appear, at least not prominently.
Then allow me to present you with the conduit for my ideas. I propose we get Elliot Doolittle elected to Congress.
That's crazy. He's not even educated.
And we are the best educators I know, but if you're afraid of a friendly wager...
What kind of a wager?
You've always been jealous that I have the larger office.
Me? Jealous? Oh, that is so petty. Although you do have a better parking spot than I do, is that included in the wager?
I'll throw in both if he doesn't win.
Really? Admittedly, there is something very appealing about those broad, folksy shoulders of his. And I suspect that underneath that scraggly beard, there could be a campaign-worthy jawline. You think he'd go for it?
There's only one way to find out.
Excuse me.
Good luck to you. All right.
I have a proposition for you.
Oh, yeah? What can I do for you?
Well, it's what we can do for one another. It seems there's a representative position open in the area.
Yeah, that's what I was telling Colleen.
Colleen, is it? Yes. Well, as you told Colleen, you're interested in becoming a candidate?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I'm just as good as the next guy. And it should be open to anybody, you know what I mean?
That does seem to be a basic tenet in this country.
Yeah, you know, I just figure, like, if you could get me, like, a little better at all the talking and stuff.
Well, that would take work.
I don't need Doolittle, I ain't afraid of a little work. I insist on paying for lessons.
I'm sure that we could work something out.
That is awesome! I'm gonna be the best down sales rep the Boston Colony Beverage Company ever had.
Yes. I'm becoming quite convinced that you would make a splendid representative.
Thank you very much.
We start work tomorrow promptly at 9.
Oh, I'll be here at 8:45.
Well,
He seems to have passed a background check. No felonies or scandals that we can find. And he volunteers at a soup kitchen over in Charlestown once a month. So he's pretty much a blank canvas.
Sounds like an ideal candidate.
Well, good morning, Mr. Doolittle. I see that you're here bright and early.
Raring to go.
Our first order of business is taking care of this.
All right, then. Let's go.
What does she mean by that? What do you mean by that?
Trust me. What's you're going to thank us later.
What's wrong with going where? Just tell me where we're going.
It's going to be fun.
Oh, no. I'm not going to a salon.
What might we be doing today?
Well, for starters, you can burn this.
What? This is my favorite hat.
That should be no one's favorite anything. Godspeed.
He's ready.
Oh.
His hair too short in the back. Well, I like little length, but his hair curls back there. I wanted a clean look.
My goodness. I do believe he looks better than we ever hoped for.
I must admit, I had my doubts at first, but it's actually been my pleasure.
It is so rare to see you speechless. I think I'm gonna really enjoy this process.
Don't be ridiculous. I was just thinking about how we need to change his wardrobe.
Mm-hmm. So, how does your new haircut feel?
Well, my neck feels like a baby's bottom. Really weird. Yeah, this place is a little bit out of my reach. I mean, I ain't got the job yet. I can't afford these kind of duds.
Oh, no, don't worry about it. We'll front you the cash. I have so much confidence that we will get you this job that you can pay us back.
Thinking something simple with a light stripe?
This all feels so partisan.
If I belong to a younger generation, I would say, Dad, he is fine.
Might I remind you that is the exact generation you're trying to rescue from such phrases?
Let me just say this, Elliot. If I didn't know you better, I'd say you looked like a young Kennedy.
Really? Mm-hmm. I feel like a total Bonnie. I said I put myself in your hands.
Don't ruin the moment by speaking. And stop slouching. Stand up straight. Nothing ruins a good suit like bad posture. Now the real work begins.
I parked the car in the far part of the yard.
No, I parked the car in the far part of the yard.
So I said I parked the car in the far part of the yard.
No, the R's. 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 You can hear the difference, can't you?
Yeah, you sound all wonky.
Perhaps you should try wonky this time, again.
I parked the car in the far part of the yard.
Good. Now let's see if we can get you to stop sounding like a pirate, having a heart attack while gargling.
Okay.
Well, Elliot Doolittle, is it? Hello?
Hey, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Oh, no. You have it all wrong. You don't lunge at whomever you're shaking hands with. One or two steps forward is fine. Confidence, but not aggression. And though the rule may have changed, it is appropriate to allow a lady to offer her hand first. One or two shakes is fine. She's not a bicycle pump. What are you doing?
I gotta take some notes. I didn't know there's so much to a simple handshake. I mean, the quick quail crossing to and fro, quietly called out, quid pro quo.
Well done, well done.
You sure we gotta do all this work for me to be a sales rep?
Well, there are all sorts of representatives, aren't there? So wouldn't you want to be prepared for whatever option presents itself?
Yeah, I guess. Oh, but wait, quid pro quo, is that a thing?
A thing. It's a Latin expression for give and take. Like an exchange of one thing for another.
Okay.
Now, mind the vowels.
Okay, but it's only been a couple of weeks. I mean, you can't expect me to be perfect yet. You know, like you guys.
You guys, excuse me.
You know what I mean, you and Colleen. Okay, I know you're not guys. I mean, you're a woman. But no, you're not. You're,
I'm not a woman?
Well, no, you are, but you're a lady. I mean, that's, is that okay? That's not, what is that word? Condescending, if I think of you as a lady?
No, that's nice. It's a lot better than you guys.
Oh, but wait, hold on a second. I looked it up. And it says, yes. So guys has become acceptable slang in referring to a group of non-gender-specific individuals.
Colleen never should have given you her annotated dictionary. Slang is the purview of the Twitter set, and it is with good reason that Twitter begins with twit.
Now let me hear the tongue twister.
How come I'm the one always trying to talk like, speak like you? I mean, not everyone in Boston speaks that way.
Much to my dismay.
You should say something regular for a change.
Why would I do that?
How did you put it? You are a practitioner of the art of language. If that's true, you should speak my dialect. You know? A little quid pro quo, as it were. Unless you can't do it.
You know, if you quit being such a chowder head, I'd get you talking so wicked good they won't even know you're down around Somerville.
That was awesome! That was killer awesome!
If you tell Colleen, I'll deny that ever happened.
Yeah, you're good. You are a practitioner of the art of language.
In 5 weeks, and the deadline to announce his candidacy is fast approaching.
Which is why I am looking for this, my lucky pen.
Is that the same lucky pen that I used to sign my campaign documents? Is this how you're going to win our friendly wager, by sabotage?
My. Politics apparently brings out the suspicious side of your nature. I admit, originally I was skeptical. But Elliot is showing some great promise. I would certainly consider voting for him over Andrew Bridgeworth. You think he's ready for a short speech?
A proper copy.
Photo op. Press release.
Great work.
State building, why are we going here first?
Well, this is where you have to file all your paperwork.
No, I'm pretty sure we just drop off the application at the beverage company.
What do you mean, beverage company? Oh, yes, about that.
That's what we've been doing this whole time, right? With all the clothes and the lessons. Get me ready to be a sales rep at the Boston Colony Beverage Company.
Actually, Elliot, we've been preparing you as a candidate for the House of Representatives in Washington, D.C. Perhaps I wasn't clear about that.
You mean like Congress? Are you out of your minds?
This is all simply just a misunderstanding.
A misunderstanding? Are you seriously? Are you kidding me right now? I mean, I think the misunderstanding is me thinking you two aren't straight up crazy. I'm gonna go put in my application at some place where everyone isn't completely insane.
Wait, Elliot. I was sure that once we got this far, he would just go along with it.
But you didn't tell him, did you?
I did. In my own way.
Your own way? Which is pretty much like a steamroller. You just decide a course of action and then roll over everybody who isn't on board?
If it's the best course of action, then why wouldn't everyone be on board?
Okay, Hannah, go ahead and be glib. This time you have really crossed the line.
Wait a minute.
as I live and breathe. Is that Elliot Doolittle?
Good morning, ladies.
My, you clean up good, son. Tell me, clean up good, Viv.
Ooh, la, la, I will say so. Good thing I'm not 20 years younger.
Oh, but why are you dressed like that? Oh, you poor dear, did someone die?
No, ma'am, nothing like that.
Oh,
I am here to get John Henkel's job as distribution rep. I've been working on some things, and I plan on being the best rep this company ever had.
You'd be real good at that. Don't you think he'd be good at that, Viv?
Awful good.
So good.
Real good.
Really good.
Too bad, though. Mr. Walters just offered the job to his nephew.
Yeah.
He did?
Yeah.
Just between us, the nephew? Let's just say he's real lucky his uncle owns a company, you know what I'm saying?
Jeez. 5 cans short of a six-pack, you know?
I mean, what are you gonna do?
What can you do?
What are you gonna do?
I'm sorry, honey.
Yeah. Well, it's no big deal.
No.
Right.
That's plenty of time.
Thank you very much.
No, I'm sorry, honey.
All right. You guys have a good day.
Sorry, anytime, honey.
Okay.
You hang
come
in there,
anytime.
Honey.
Oh,
that breaks my heart.
Oh, man,
that broke my heart.
But it's been 3 days, and we haven't seen hide nor hair of Elliot Doolittle. It seems we have two courses of action. You can either admit defeat.
When have I ever given up on anything?
Or we can resort to more drastic measures, and you could apologize.
Oh, all right, I'm sorry.
Hannah, I'm sorry. Don't apologize to me. Apologize to Mr. Doolittle.
You were practicing.
Oh, was it?
You know, proper manners would dictate that you invite me in.
Suit yourself.
It's a lovely picture. Cute kids. I didn't realize you were married.
One of a number of things you failed to ask me.
I suppose I deserve that.
I'm not married. It's my sister Bonnie and her family. Frank died in a construction accident a few years back.
I'm so sorry to hear that. Did he have life insurance?
Life insurance? Do you know where you are? People around here are lucky enough to just have a job.
There's a job opening up in Congress.
And you decided to put me up for it all by yourself, without my consent. Why? Isn't your world, you think I talk like an idiot, so I must be one?
No, you're not an idiot. That's quite obvious. We never could have accomplished such great things in such a short period of time. You have an amazingly keen ear. Your grasp of phonetics and the way you've adapted your grammar, it's quite remarkable, really. I've never taught anyone like you.
You think you can just drop by here and flatter me a little, is that it?
Flattery is beneath me.
Then what exactly are you doing here?
You have such amazing potential. When I think of the things that we could accomplish, and you have the audacity to accuse me of treating you unfairly, okay, fine. Fine. But maybe some of this is your fault, too.
What?
It infuriates me to see how low you have set your own bar. Carrying kegs and fixing pipes is all fine and good, but if you think that's the limit of your capabilities, then perhaps you are an idiot.
To see you.
It's very nice to see you, too.
Well, I must admit, the office has been a little dull these past few days.
I understand.
I trust everything is well?
Things are great.
Good.
Helmet comes off, puck right into the face, loses a tooth, they still stop the puck. I mean, he's the toughest guy you've ever met.
Isn't this cozy?
Oh, Elliot was just teaching me a few hockey terms. Ask me what a hat trick is.
I really wouldn't dare.
Oh, I forgot to ask. How's it going at the beverage company? I'm sure they are so lucky to have you.
A job went to the boss's nephew. You know how it is.
I'm sorry to hear that. I really am.
So this is why I came back here. Got that. Sorry, I tried to fold it.
Is that it? I was hoping that Hannah's apology might make you rethink our campaign.
Apology? That's interesting. She did say that I was infuriating, and then she said it was my fault. And then, right before she stomped out of the house, she stated that I very well might be an idiot. So, you know, admittedly, you know language better than I do, but I don't think that's what apology means.
Hannah, is that true?
That is an absolute fabrication. I do not stomp.
Uh-huh. Granted, but you were supposed to go over to Elliot's to offer him an apology, did you?
In a manner of speaking, at the very least, it was implied.
Yeah, but I certainly couldn't have inferred it.
Oh, you wouldn't even know what that word means if I hadn't been drilling vocabulary into your skull for the last 6 weeks.
Even so, Elliot, you have come quite out of your way merely to return just a scarf. So if Hannah were to apologize for railroading you...
Railroading him?
Shh. Would you consider our proposal?
Well, it depends on the apology.
I see, Hannah.
Elliot, there seems to have been a misunderstanding. I assumed incorrectly that you had enough information to make a sensible decision and join us of your own accord.
You see, in that apology, some of the words seem to obscure the I'm sorry part.
Well, perhaps you will let me show you what I mean by objectives and sensible decision. This is the educational enrichment program that I chaired for the last 6 years.
Is that like a practice school for teachers?
No, we take educational theories and put them into actual classrooms. Colleen and I have focused most of our efforts on programs to help learning disabled children using visual interactive techniques. We've had a lot of success with pilot programs all over Boston. Students with dyslexia, for example, have difficulty understanding numbers in their conceptual form. This technique allows them to associate numbers with structures, and using their hands allows for greater long-term comprehension.
Aria?
X equals 127.5.
Exactly.
Our plan is to get schools to adopt these programs nationwide.
What about you? What made you become an educator?
People lose things.
Yeah, tell me about it. Last week, my sister just couldn't find her keys. We found them in the fridge.
Well, I was thinking more on a larger scale. Like this car, for example. Vehicles get lost or stolen all the time. People lose their homes in fires. Businesses go bankrupt at an alarming rate. These major things in which we put such stock can be so easily lost.
Yeah, I get that. I mean, a lot of our neighbors have been foreclosed.
The same could be said about a lot of people, I guess. My mom passed away when I was 8, and my dad basically raised me and my little sister. He taught me that the one thing in life that could never be taken away is education. That's why our educational program and others like it are so important. We give children something that can never be lost. That's something that I was hoping to take to Washington. That's something I was hoping you would take to Washington.
Do you really think I could do this? Like, get elected and help people?
I do. But the important thing is that you believe it yourself. I hope you'll consider it.
Okay.
Okay, you'll consider it?
No, I just did. I'm in.
Thank you.
race for vacant congressional seat. I guess you really know you made it when the papers are calling you a local man.
Yeah, real funny. You're cracking me up over here.
Hey, Elliot, when you get down there to Washington, you should appoint one of them commissions to find out why the Celtics ain't got no outside game no more.
And you should pass a law saying my wife can't start yelling at me until at least 5 minutes after I get in the door.
Happy hours, at least 3 hours. I mean, come on.
This is a top priority. I'm going to get right on it.
And, you know, my mom's pills.
Yeah.
She's been taking the same medication all the time, and it seems like every year they keep jacking up the cost. Somebody should do something.
I think you're right.
I've reworked the speech for the PAC meeting.
Pierce, when Elliot gets here, will you have him come see me?
There's someone here to see you.
I'd like a word or two with him myself.
And you would be?
Isma, why? You don't see the resemblance?
Hannah, so lovely to meet you. This is Colleen.
Hello.
Hey. I come down so as me and you can have us a talk. You know, man or woman, oh.
Can I offer you something to drink?
You wouldn't happen to have a beer handy?
No, no, I'm afraid we don't.
Coffee or tea, perhaps?
Can you make that coffee Irish? Nah? Well, I'm good then.
Care to step into my office? It's funny, we did a background check on Elliot before the campaign. There was no mention of his mother.
Well, probably because we ain't got the same last name. If you want to get all proper about it, I'm Allie O'Malley, Doolittle McLaren Dabrowski. Ain't that a mouthful?
Certainly is.
As long as we're being blunt here, might as well come right out with it. What's the racket you're running?
Racket?
No need to play coy with me, sister. I know the folks give you money when you run for office. That Bridgeworth fella's loaded. So maybe you shake him down for some so Elliot will drop out of the race, right? Being his ma and all, I figure I'm entitled to part of the take.
Oh, no, no, you have it all wrong. We are intent on getting your son elected to Congress.
Oh, so you're running the long con is what you're doing. You get him into office, you get the kickbacks from the lobbyists, so-called appearance fees, and don't think I ain't heard all that PAC money.
We believe your son's candidacy could actually help people.
My Elliot?
Mm-hmm.
You gotta be kidding me. That boy's always had more heart than brains. But if he's gonna be helping people, he might as well start with yours truly here. I figure it might be worth your while, so give me a little something-something. One of them stipends or stipends, whatever you call it. You could consider me a consultant on how to handle my kid. There's my baby boy! Oh!
Ma, what are you doing here?
Oh, looky there! You got him all dolled up! I get the impression you won't want me showing up at every campaign stop. Especially since my biggest question to anybody running for office is how they plan on preparing for the oncoming zombie apocalypse. And that ain't gonna go over well with Elliot here, because he's afraid of zombies.
Is that so? We discovered your Achilles heel?
What? No. I mean, listen, zombies are unsettling, we can all agree. But wait, hold on a sec. Are you gonna let her turn this into a deliberation on zombies?
Deliberation. Listen to Mr. Fanny.
How much cash do we have in the office?
You are not seriously considering paying her.
She is threatening to show up at every campaign event. Plus, it'll give us insight into Elliot's history. We're prepared to make you a deal. How does a grand sound?
What? No, no, no. Do not encourage her. She is
not. Shut up. Grown-ups are talking here. Now, that's way too generous. With that kind of money, I'd feel obligated to use it for something useful, like put it on the rent. I just want to go have me a good time with some friends, get my drink on, maybe put some money down on a pony or two. It's all 150, but as much as I could spend without feeling too bad about it.
You drive a hard bargain, but you got yourself a deal.
Huh.
One of the most highly respected countries, I mean, nations. Nation, what is my problem?
You've practiced this speech 1,000 times. Just relax.
Relax? Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. That's easy for you to say. Relax.
Elliot, she's right. And the Boston Civic Alliance is practically on your side already. They were big supporters of Hannah's. And their president, Humphrey Rossdale, was my co-chair over at New England Preparatory.
After the speech, just stick to generalities when talking to people.
and breathe. The first rule is always to just keep breathing.
America has gone from being one of the most highly educated nations to 33rd. As your representative in Congress, I will pledge to make education a top priority.
He's doing very well.
Yeah, we need to relax his gestures.
In closing,
but we're okay.
It is my sincere desire that we guarantee no child in our schools is denied access to the lifetime advantages that only education can provide. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Mr. Doolittle. What are your thoughts about the current cuts and how they're affecting education?
We didn't prepare for a Q&A.
Well,
the cuts deeply affect our schools. You know, an example is my niece. Her favorite teacher, Mrs. Gunther, was laid off. And she was transferred to an already overcrowded classroom. We need to figure out another way to balance the budget because the ones paying for these cuts are the children.
Where did that come from? He's actually fielding the question.
It's like the Three Stooges.
Oh, dear.
You know how it is when Mo pokes Curly in the eyes?
And we just lost Hillary Townsend's vote.
Yeah, I think that's the least of her worries.
Well, that's what it's like with our kids. Except we're not giving them the tools to stop it. To go like this. So I'm asking you, do you really want Mo gouging our kids in the eyes?
Thank you.
Yeah.
We'd like to thank Mr. Doolittle for speaking to us today. Remember, we are just 5 weeks away from the special election, and now we'll adjourn for tea and cake.
Thank you so much.
Hey. I must say, there is a folksy populism to him. According to our straw polls, he's leading Andrew Bridgeworth by 3-1 with women voters.
We're working on broadening his frame of reference.
You mean the Q&A? I love the Three Stooges. I think he's onto something there.
Hold on, I'm gonna fight. All right.
We'll work on aspects of your speech, but for your first foray into public speaking, you did really well.
Yeah? Thank you. You know, I was a little scared at first, but, you know, after a while, it's just like being me, you know, talking to people.
Hey.
Hey, Bond.
So, you must be the mystery lady I was hearing so much about, huh? I was wondering when we was gonna get a look at you.
Hannah, allow me to introduce you to my sister, Bonnie Cleary. This is Hannah Higgins.
Pleasure to meet you.
Oh, no, trust me, sis. The pleasure's all mine. Scooch, you want to do me a favor? Go check on Junior for me. He was heading to the backyard with his little league bat and smashed something face.
Scooch?
Oh, no, that's nothing.
No, see, it's from when we was kids. You had to watch this one all the time. He'd scooch out his clothes, go running down the block.
You know, Bon, I don't think she wants to hear about that.
Maybe I do.
Oh, yeah, neighbors was always bringing him back, wrapped in dish towels.
I'm gonna go check on Junior. I'll see you in the morning.
You better scooch out of that soup first.
Yeah, I'm gonna scooch you.
Oh, it was lovely to meet you.
What's your rush? You should come in for coffee.
Oh, I really should be on my way.
No. You're coming in for coffee. You and me should have a little chat. Besides, you parked right here already, even, huh? Oh, no, don't sweat it. Your car will be fine, huh? Hey, John! John! This lady's a friend of mine, okay? So her car's gonna be fine, okay? If not, I'm gonna hunt you down and make earrings out of your kidneys, okay? Right this way. Make yourself comfortable. Not there. That chair's wicked rickety.
Oh.
don't know what I would have done without my kid brother there. We was barely scraping by before my husband Frank died, and after. Well, he was barely in the ground before the wolves from the bank started threatening to throw us out of here. I got something of a proud streak. I'd rather chew off an arm than ask for help, so I didn't say nothing. First thing I know, there was Elliot. He's standing in the hall. He'd given up his apartment. He'd sold all his stuff. He's standing there with a check for a security deposit and everything he had in the bank. We're not on Easy Street by a long shot, but thanks to him, not on the street neither. Coffee's ready. I'll let you doctor it up yourself. I'm always afraid I'll put too much in one or the other.
Thank you.
So what's going on with you and my brother? I mean, he gets with you, and all of a sudden he's talking different. He's dressing different. He's getting these big ideas in his head about running for office.
I appreciate your directness. It frustrates me when women sidestep an issue for the sake of politeness.
That had never been my problem.
Let me assure you that in no way did your brother get with me. Even so, he is an adult and he's free to conduct his own affairs.
Hey, don't get your Irish up. I got good reason for asking. He's a grown man, yeah, but he's also a nice guy, and women have taken advantage of that in the past. Always getting him to do crazy stuff. That started with Ma.
The inimitable Allie?
I'm not even sure what that means, but I take it by that you've met her. She's a piece of work, huh, Ma, huh?
Yes, she is a piece of work.
You still haven't answered my question.
You want to know what my intentions are towards your brother?
Yeah.
I intend to run him for Congress.
I got that part. Look, what I'm asking is, what are your intentions? You know, personal.
You misunderstand the situation. I intend to get your brother elected to Congress. In no way do we have a personal relationship.
Honey, every relationship is personal. You don't believe that? Maybe you got the misunderstanding of the situation.
I am deeply offended. I am offended by the way that you are characterizing my position on the issues.
And how do you respond?
I didn't mean to upset her.
No, she's not upset. She's Andrew Bridgeworth.
Oh.
And he probably will say something like that to get you to fly off the handle and say something rash. And don't talk to me. I'm the moderator. Talk to the voters in the audience.
Right. Okay, sorry. Let's do it again.
I am appalled, I tell you, about how you have misrepresented my position.
Perhaps my mistake has been to imply that my opponent actually has a position. Because frankly, besides offering vague political platitudes, I have yet to hear Mr. Bridgeworth take a solid stand on any of the matters that we all face. I think the voters deserve better than that.
I think you're ready.
Yes, I am ready to represent the hardworking people of the state of Massachusetts.
No, I was being Hannah that time.
Oh. Right, sorry. Well, thank you. A man of the people, right? Well, the people you're referencing, this is what we do.
No, you're not seriously gonna make me wear those, are you? Do you know how many feet have been in there?
Relax, Cinderella. No one has ever died from bowling shoes. Or bowling, for that matter. So, take your shoes. Smile for the cameras.
Thank you, everyone, for coming out tonight. I really look forward to hearing your thoughts about what I should do in Washington, but first, let's roll a few.
You all right?
Yeah, nothing wounded but my pride.
Knowing you, that'll recover in no time.
Oh, go ball! Go ball! Go!
Yes! Oh, there it is! One more turn. Throw one more. Oh, yo, yes!
I'm just getting started.
It's kind of a situation.
I agree.
Maybe not with anyone else.
Right to me. All right, thanks so much. I really appreciate it.
That's the third bunch of guys that have said the same thing.
You know that big road construction project that's supposed to bring in all these new jobs? The contract's all but been awarded to High Park Construction, a subsidiary of Abcorp.
Which is owned by Andrew Bridgeworth.
Exactly, and they plan on bringing in all their own men. They probably won't be doing any local hires.
And that sort of thing is only going to get worse if he's elected to Congress.
I thought tonight was very informative, and I look forward to taking your thoughts and concerns with me to Washington. Thank you. Thank you very much for your support. Any questions?
Ms. Higgins, last year you lost a bid for the same congressional seat Mr. Doolittle's running for. Do you find it easier to be running a campaign instead of being a candidate yourself?
Each one presents its own challenges, but I feel that Elliot is exactly the kind of man we all need, representing our interests.
Have you seen your bowling video?
Bowling video?
Video's already going viral. 20,000 hits.
All of my life, I've been involved in education. Tonight, I was reminded that there is nothing more educational than, as my colleague Elliot would put it, as falling on my butt.
We're 2 weeks out from the election, and the latest polling numbers have us out front of Bridgeworth by 7 points.
I have to take this. Would you give me a moment? Elliot Doolittle.
But it looks like in the men over 50 demographic, our lead narrows.
Right, yes, they do seem to be Bridgeworth's biggest supporters.
How do we reach those people?
I have to leave for an hour or two.
Is everything okay?
Oh, yeah, it's fine. It's just a family thing.
I know exactly how much dough is in my breast. Don't think I ain't gonna count it.
I'd expect no less.
Now, Allie, I don't want to hear about no more altercations at the racetrack.
Why don't you pick on someone your own size? Ain't that what they always say?
Ma, you punched a jockey.
Anybody'd have done the same. That filly was a sure thing. On the outside, he ran her right along the fence.
Hey, you're just lucky that little fella isn't pressing charges. Figures he's never going to hear the end of it around the paddock if they know he got his clock cleaned by an old lady.
Tell me that old lady one more time. See if I don't climb across that counter and give you some.
Ma, settle down. Let's just get out of here. Come on, get your stuff. All right. Thank you.
No problem, Ellie. Hey, see if you can keep her out of here for, I don't know, 6 months this time?
Yeah, right.
Good luck.
Thinking about voting for Elliot Doolittle? Think again. Elliot Doolittle claims he's a man
of
the
people.
Exactly what kind of people is he talking about? Elliot Doolittle is not just soft on crime. Elliot Doolittle maintains an ongoing relationship with a repeat offender. Are you willing to elect a member of a crime family to Congress?
I'm Andrew Bridgeworth, and I approve this message.
Oh, crime family, first of all, that ad is positively libelous. And second, how is getting arrested in keeping with our agreement to lay low? I want my $150 back!
I stand behind all the statements we've made in our ads.
These accusations are salacious.
Do you mean fallacious?
Yeah, that too.
Are you saying Mr. Bridgeworth is lying?
Well, technically, no. The crime family part is misleading. It's ridiculous.
Okay, my mother has a record. I think we all have family members that do things we might not agree with. Do I support all the choices that my mother has ever made? No. Do I support my mother? Always. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, you guys are too kind to come out here. It's 5:30 in the morning. We should all be back in bed, so I really appreciate you coming out this early.
In our children's future. We have 33rd in the world, right? Smaller classrooms. There's too many kids.
We need scholarships, math and science scholarships. It is my number one priority.
No, please tell Sarah I need her.
I know what it's like to struggle from paycheck to paycheck. I struggled to make ends meet and to provide for my loved ones, and that is the perspective that I'm going to bring with me to Washington.
Oh, please tell me that's the last one.
I promise.
Okay.
I think we're ready.
Yeah. Yeah. So, well, I guess we should say goodnight. Tomorrow's big day.
Right. Goodnight.
How do you feel about me?
About you?
Yeah. You know, my chances in the election. Like, are you scared? Are you nervous? I have a hard time reading you sometimes. And by sometimes, I mean always.
Oh. Am I nervous? At this point, I think we've done all we can. We've addressed the issues. We've stated our positions. It's all in the voters' hands at this point. And there's nothing to be nervous about.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, there's no reason to be nervous.
Why are you?
I am, like, crazy nervous.
Like, I know exactly what you mean. It's so not like me.
I'm, like, 50% kid night before Christmas. I'm 50% kid, like, on a scary high dive. And then I'm 50%, like, I don't even know what.
Well, that would be really
add up. I know that the numbers don't add up, but, like, this whole thing doesn't add up. I mean, think about me 3 months ago, and then think about me now. Tomorrow, I could be a United States congressman. That is... It's mind-blowing.
I know exactly what you mean. I was never this nervous during my own campaign. I was so logical. Everything was so clear. Now, I don't know, things are different. I'm sorry. I'm usually not at a loss for words.
That is true. Anna, I want you to know how grateful I am for everything that you've done, and I hope, no matter what happens tomorrow, that I don't disappoint you.
Whatever happens, I don't think you ever could.
Elliot Doolittle, you got my vote.
Oh, thank you very much.
All right. Hey, can I pick your brain for a second?
Yeah.
I've got some ideas I wouldn't mind running by you.
I'm gonna say goodnight.
So anyway,
good night.
Great.
Oh, well, there are going to be photographers there, right? Yeah.
So would it be a problem if Bonnie and the kids came with us? You know, the kids are really excited, but Bonnie didn't want to intrude. She thought it was like a date or something.
A date? To vote? No, that would be so silly, right?
Right? Yeah, so silly. Okay.
Right?
Right? Yeah. Okay. All right. Hey, guys, let's go. Okay. There we go. All right,
hey,
be careful.
Hey, slow down. Knock it off. Walls are open all day.
Take it easy on them. There's kids.
Right. If you had my morning, you'd be yelling too.
Hi. Thank you very much.
Buckle up. Buckle up.
Yeah. They know how cars work. All right. All right.
Everybody set? Fingers and toes?
Yes. Remember, you're 18.
Polls are opening early this morning as the special election gets underway. Already, there are reports of heavy voter turnout in this hotly contested race between political outsider Elliot Doolittle and businessman Andrew Bridgeworth.
Okay, Elliot Doolittle, I have worked with him for the last 8 years, and he never called in once. That is responsibility.
Exit polling shows a significant blue-collar turnout for Elliot Doolittle. The beer vendor turned congressional candidate has jumped out to an early lead over his rival, Andrew Bridgeworth.
Ah, that Elliot. He's one of our own.
He's like family around
here. He's practically like a, not like a son. No, because not one of us.
We're not really old enough to have a son that age. No. More like a kid brother.
Oh, I like that. That's good.
How about we pick you up?
One time, I seen him juggle 3 kegs. Okay, they were mini kegs and they was empties. But in my book, anybody who can do that is cut out for that circus in Washington. Know what I'm saying?
As a wider sampling of exit polls comes in, Andrew Bridgeworth seems to be taking the lead over Elliot Doolittle.
You know, all that talk that Bridgeworth fellow was spreading was lies. Crime family? Ha! I'd like to get a hold of that guy and give him a wicked case of what for. That's what I would do.
For those of us on the ground here, the race is still too close to call, with Doolittle now moving ahead of Bridgeworth.
You know, if Elliot gets elected,
folks around here are going to want to
party.
Oh, Mike, we're going to have us a ripper. Oh, it's not like we don't have enough beer for it. It's going to be a mad ripper.
A wicked mad ripper. What?
With nearly 75% of the polling places now closed, it appears that Andrew Bridgeworth has a small but significant lead over Elliot Doolittle.
How much I appreciate your support. In particular, I'd like to thank Hannah Higgins and Colleen Pickering for the unenviable task of guiding me through this entire process. It has been a thrilling journey, one that has led me to be standing before you this evening. Nearly all the precincts have been counted. The margin is razor thin. But it is now time to offer my congratulations to my opponent on a well-fought campaign and wish him the best as our newest United States Congressman. No.
Wait.
It's okay. While we concede the election, I want all of you to know that in no way does this nullify your involvement
or diminish the ideals that you've embraced. We will continue to work hard to accomplish our goals.
I hope you will do the same.
Thank you very much.
Oh, you're gonna get him next time.
I'm not sure I have a next time plan, but thank you for your kind words.
I don't know. I really liked Elliot Doolittle, so it was hard to decide. But then there was all that stuff the other guys were saying, and it made it even harder to decide.
When I think about all the struggles and the sacrifices I went through raising my kid and his sister, poor single man, I'll break your heart.
Maybe they could do a TV movie about me. Who can I talk to about that, huh? Who can I...
Don't touch that.
Let me tell you, even if he wasn't blood, I'd still vote for him. Because you are just not going to find a more stand-up kind of guy than Elliot Doolittle.
At the very least, it was a noble defeat.
You can keep your nobility. I wish we had taken the kid gloves off and wiped the floor with that Bridgeworth creep.
Why, Miss Higgins, if I didn't know better, I would swear you have gone from being an idealist to a politician.
It has been a thrilling journey.
He did give a lovely concession speech.
One never would have guessed he was delivering beer kegs a few months ago.
Well, kudos to you, I suppose.
Kudos to us both.
I guess I'll be moving into your office pretty soon.
Yes, fair is fair. I fully plan on squaring things up between the two of us.
Good. And Elliot? What about the two of you?
Oh, please. Don't be ridiculous. There's no two of us. I actually was just thinking about how it's time to release our charge back into the wild.
Really? How do you propose to return him back to his natural habitat?
Suppose we could just open the doors and let him run free.
You think he'd just wander out?
We could drop him off at a hockey game with a six-pack of beer.
Terrible.
Stop. Okay, if you insist on being so gentle, I suppose I could pin a note to him and leave him in a basket outside an Irish pub. You can just put it in the trunk. What are you doing?
You want the clothes back too, right?
What? Why would I want your clothes?
For the next guy you experiment on.
Don't you mean on whom we decide to experiment?
Whatever.
Okay, this was a rough night on all of us, but you don't need to take it out on me. Go home, have yourself a beer, and you'll feel better in the morning.
I'll tell you what. Why don't you just drop me off at a hockey game with a six-pack of beer? Or maybe you could leave me in a basket outside an Irish pub.
If I had known that you were so thin-skinned, I would have checked earshot. But obviously you're intent on extracting an apology from me, so I will indulge you. I'm deeply sorry if I offended you.
Really? Don't patronize me after what I've done for you.
For me, you came to me wanting to be a beverage rep. I think that you're more than qualified to go back to your beer and your Bruins. You're welcome.
Don't act like you've done me favors, okay? I was pretty happy before. I was happy taking care of my own family, doing the occasional good deed downtown.
I showed you that we are all required to stand up against inequality, complacency, and injustice. How awful of me.
But you always said that we could accomplish something together, right? And now we have one setback and you're ready to call it quits.
I would call it a lot more than a setback. We lost the election.
And how quickly after that did you decide to dump me?
I'm not gonna hold your hand. Yes, there are things that are wrong with this world. You are a grown-up. Go out there, do something, make a difference.
Can I help you?
Excuse me.
Oh, great. Another stalker with a camera. That's the perfect way to end this.
Any luck?
Wires are shot.
Okay, well, don't sweat it. Have a beer.
Thank you.
You don't gotta fix the buzzer. She comes to see you, I'm sure she can knock like a normal human being.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No? You've been mooning around here for the last couple of days.
Mooning? I've been mooning.
Yeah, yeah. You're like a lost pup. Jeez, just go talk to him.
Nope. We had a fight.
We had a fight. What's that mean?
It means it's done. It's over, bud.
You don't know that.
She said.
She said it. Oh, all right. And of course, you've been in politics long enough to know that people never say things they don't mean. I miss fighting.
That's crazy.
No, it ain't. You know Frank and I loved each other, but sometimes I get on his nerves.
Really? It's hard to believe, sister.
Oh, he'd do something so absolutely knuckleheaded. Just
bam, gloves would come off, we'd be going the rounds, you know. But no matter how loud or ticked off we'd get, it was okay, you know? Just shaking the dust off. It was like it meant we were both still in it. We were still paying attention. Yeah. The day I figured out I could fight with that man was the day I figured out I could marry him.
Well, you know, she's different, Vaughn. She's got no reason to be around me, you know, or us, or this place, you know? She's got no reason.
Well, maybe you should stop hanging out around here. Go give her a reason.
I think he'd be hard to find.
I didn't realize that knocking had gone out of fashion.
Oh, I didn't realize it was required, considering your door was open.
That's no excuse for sneaking up on me.
Well, your definition of sneaking leaves room for debate.
Am I leaving myself open for a debate?
Hannah, you've been trying to start an argument for the better part of a week now. That doesn't give you any reason to get all wicked smart with me.
Why do you insist on speaking that way? You are just trying to goad me.
Hannah, I know you are valiantly trying to defend the English language, but it is alive and well. English has been changing ever since we first spoke it, and it will continue to evolve until we have spoken the last of it. But you and I both know the issue at hand has nothing to do with slang.
I don't think that you have any idea, actually.
I do. You and I have been partners for 10 years. I've known you since you were a little girl. I think I have a very good idea of what's going on.
Stranger, why don't you come on in? Just put up a fresh pot of coffee.
Yes,
So is Elliot?
No, I got no idea where that brother of mine is.
You're saying he left?
No. No, I'm saying he took off this morning without so much as a see you later.
I see.
I seen your little dust up outside the hotel. It was on the internet.
Yes, that. Seems everyone has cameras on his or her cell phone these days. Well, you're probably really busy, so I won't take up more of your time. Thank you for the coffee.
You want I should tell Elliot you stopped by?
Yes, I suppose I do. I'm not really sure why I came. In fact, if you must say anything, tell him things are going really well at the office. The most noticeable difference is how much more room there is. He really did seem to take up a lot of space.
Yeah. He's a big fellow, my brother.
And loud, too. I'm sure that you've noticed. It's amazing how much quieter things are now that he's not in the office. Which is good, because so much had been neglected due to the campaign. Things are really, really busy at work. Which is good, because it's amazing how much slower time passes now that he's not around.
Perhaps it's better if you say nothing at all.
Say nothing to whom? Professor Higgins, good afternoon.
How are you?
Quite well.
Thank you for asking.
I guess I should be getting back to the office.
Well, say hi to Colleen for me. I owe her a lot.
Just her?
Well, I think the biggest difference in me now isn't how I speak or how I act, but how I expect to be treated. Before Colleen had any reason to, she treated me like a gentleman. But you treated me like an experiment.
Oh, for crying out loud, I treat everybody that way. I really should go.
Ow!
It's more where that came from. Go get her.
Go! Get her! Go, go, go!
Anna! I have a proposition.
I'm listening.
You were right, you know? And I decided I should do something. So just downtown in a meeting with a political consultant. There's a lot that can be done right here in Boston. The mayor's up for re-election, and a lot of people agree that he's vulnerable to the right candidate.
I get it. I think you would be a great candidate.
I'm not. You have the passion, you have the ideas. It's just your people skills that are a little lacking. It's not an insult, it's just a fact, but it's a fact I can help you with.
I don't know. After that failed bid for Congress and those embarrassing internet videos.
No, well, that's a funny thing about those. They're not liabilities. The consultant I met with, he did some polling. The words and phrases that people are using most often in reference to you are feisty, human, and someone I'd like to have a beer with.
Really?
Now, I just gotta find someone who can teach you about beer.
Or bowling. I'd really like to get better at bowling.
Class is writing to army soldiers in Bosnia.
A letter brought them together.
Are you asking me out on a date?
I think I am.
It's about time you got that part of your heart working again.
A promise could drive them apart.
And what happens to us when you go overseas again?
Let's jump off that bridge we get to, all right?
Lori Loughlin, Johnny Messner, in a Hallmark Movies and Mysteries presentation, Meet My Mom, tomorrow night at 9 on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries.